Hey guys, look what we have here. Oh, by the way, it's Videodrome by DIY3DTech.com, and we're going to be taking a look at this, the Mavic. Oh, wait, no. This, I thought they were sending me a Mavic. Oh, I guess it's the E52 TX Pocket Drone instead, not the Mavic. So I just couldn't resist buying this. I got it off Banggood. I was on there getting some other pieces of this and that, and I saw this and I just went, hey, I've got to have this for under 40 bucks to get this pocket drone. And I'm going to show you a little bit why I got this, because I just think this is could be a really, really cool toy. So let's go ahead and open up the box. But yeah, one of the things you'll notice that it came a little bit beat up. It shipped from California to me, and basically this is how it shipped. It came with a plastic wrapper around it and a little bit of foam, but not enough to keep it from being a little bit damaged. So I'm hoping that this isn't going to affect it. I'm not going to be sad when I open up the box, because now, since it's around 40 bucks, I opted all in and I got the Supreme Deluxe version, and that looks okay. Hey, look at this. I even got a GPS dash hole. Oh no, I think that's for the phone. So one of the reasons that I did get this is it struck me, number one, is it folds up completely like the Mavic, and it is really, really light. Now, the camera is adjustable. Now, as I understand it, this is only a 640 by 480 camera, which is probably one of the more disappointing points about this, even though it is a crappy quadcopter. Maybe I should start a channel, Crappy Quadcopters, but if it was 720p, I think that would be really cool. And I think this day and age, 720p should be pretty much the bottom line norm instead of this VGA nonsense. But as you can see, the propellers and everything fold out, sort of like the Mavic. And it's actually pretty cool in size. So, you know, it's about 6 inches end to end, or for my metric friends, about 150 millimeters. And the props are probably pretty close to the same, probably about 140 if you want to become technical. And the prop size themselves are about 70 millimeters each, or for my English or Imperial friends, a little about 2 3/4 inches. And I'm going to throw this over here, get this out of the way. Now there is a lithium battery in this, it comes with it, and it sort of sticks in here. There we go, we got it out. There's not, the battery is, it's a proprietary battery, but it's got a JT connector in here, you can kind of see. And the battery takes up only about half of this, so I think there's, what I am going to try to do is see if I can find a different type of battery for this, because you can see the plug here just takes, a female end, and you can just stick it on here and you could put a battery in here. And what I'm going to try doing is 3D printing a cover for this to put a larger battery, because there's like, this is half empty. So I think that could be pretty cool. And then it comes with a neat little charger here, and charges off USB. It comes with a couple extra props. I'm also kind of wondering where you can order extra props for this, because it looks like a prop breaker, because these are really, really fragile little props. I'm going to have some fun with this, so I don't want to have to worry about props. They look like they screw on there with a tiny Phillips screw. But this is the other side of the JT connector and plugs in here, and you plug it into your what do you want to call it? USB port. That's what this is called, the USB port. I remembered. Ah, but now, here's the sort of gimmick with this. It's controlled by a cell phone app. So one of the things you do is there's supposed to be a QR code in here somewhere. And I don't see it, but it says it's supposed to be a QR code somewhere around here. But it's the UFO app. It's basically the app they all use where you use the cell phone to control it. So, because one of the things I thought is, wouldn't it be just really cool to be able to have something like this to throw in Well, I really don't want to say in the glove compartment of your car because that could get pretty hot with the lithium battery in there. It might not be a good thing. But the props, I think, will take a little bit of work to get folded up in there. But because this is so small and so light, you could actually even sort of travel with this to take some shots that you could probably not get otherwise, even with such a hokey thing. And for $40, if it breaks or you forget it in China or something like that, who really cares, right? So this could be kind of interesting. Now there's no SD card in here, so it records from the app very much like the Simas do. So I think that's one of the reasons for the low grade video, but it would be, I think, cool. And I'd be even be willing to pay more for this with an SD card in here. We put an SD card. Now, as I believe this does have altitude hold, so that's another big advantage of this for $40. Now, again, I went for, I think, the $36 version, and it comes with this high-grade remote control with a whole lot of buttons here and a power button, and this thing that allows you to clip on a phone, but you don't need to have this controller, and I forget what all these buttons do, but they're all purportedly in the manual, but it's, you know, your atypical stuff. And this usually, you know, it was kind of nice of them. They took this screw out of the back for me. And so it uses four AA batteries. And you don't have to use this, but this is a nice addition. Now, I'll show you guys in a future video. I got this. I splurged, I think, another $10 or $15 to get this controller. So I can clamp my phone in there. Because I want to try some interesting video projects with this. Because, yes, I know it's crappy video, but sometimes crappy video can be of value, too. And I just wanted to experiment with this. But, I still... You know, being able to take this to, you know, I kind of go back to, it's like a camera. So I've done fine art photography now for, oh, geez, pretty close to 40 years now. But I still go back to, I've had medium format cameras, all kinds of expensive cameras, blah, blah, blah. But the best camera is the camera you use. And I feel the same thing, and I look at the drone in the same light. The best drone camera is the camera you use. So if you have something like this, you know, and you want to fly it into when I say a stupid place, I don't mean a dangerous place or somewhere you're going to cause harm to others. But in other words, put this drone at risk where you may not get it back. Would you do that with a $1,000 Mavic? No. Would I do this with a $40 Wi-Fi eSheen copter? Absolutely. And so that's one of the reasons I got this guy. So it looks like it's going to be a lot of fun to fly. I've seen a couple other reviews on the interweb on this guy, and pretty straightforward flyer and all that. So I'm looking forward to it. You know, I'm sure not great range. And I'm hoping with the transmitter here, I'll get a little bit better range, because I want to try some cemetery flying. Oh, I'm giving away a little bit of the forward-looking story. Some cemetery project. So, and again, the camera is not going to be of a big importance, because obviously I'm going to add effects to it. So if I have to upscale from 640 to 720, it's not going to be a huge problem, because I'm going to add grain and stuff anyway, right? So it'll just add to the effects. So I'm really interested to see how this works. Also messing around with the grandkids and stuff like that, I think this would be a lot of fun. Because again, you can just take it to the beach, pull it out, run it with your cell phone. You can leave this behind. You don't need this, which is pretty cool. But when you do want to use it, you have this with you. And again, I thought it'd be cool for the grandkids to play with too, with the remote control additionally. And, fly it around, do selfies and that kind of stuff. So we'll see how it goes. And we'll fly it in a future video. And I'll show you all the details of that. So anyways, just want to do a quick unboxing to show you what comes with it and show you about it. And so I'm going to go ahead and charge it in a future video from here. We'll do some flight testing with it out in the cemetery and see how it works. So tell you what, don't forget, subscribe button's coming up over there. Questions, hit me down below. And hey, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.